On the news tonight, Inspector General of Police assures citizens of adequate security ahead of governorship election. In business, Nati reports Nigeria loses $16 billion production sharing contract in 10 years. And on the foreign scene, U.S. deadly tornado kills 23 in Lee County, Alabama. A very lovely evening to you. Many thanks for joining us on our flagship news tonight on Superscreen Television. I am Precious Amayo, and we'll begin with the report that ahead of the governorship and state assembly elections, Acting Inspector General of Police Mohammed Adamu has reassured the nation and the international community of the police unwavering commitment to work with the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, and other security agencies towards guaranteeing a peaceful and secure space for Nigerians to exercise their electoral franchise. The Acting Inspector General of Police made this known at the post-presidential National Assembly Elections Evaluation Meeting with strategic police managers today in Abuja. Adamu also confirmed the death of two police officers as a result of violence in some parts of the country during the presidential and National Assembly elections.
Updated statistics resulting from the presidential and National Assembly elections show that a total number of 323 offenders have so far been arrested for various electoral offenses and sundry crimes across the country. Two officers also paid the supreme price with their lives, while some others were assaulted and injured. As we perfect our plans for the governorship and state assembly elections, I also want to reassure the nation and the international community of our unwavering commitment of the Nigeria Police to work closely with INEC and sister security agencies towards guaranteeing a peaceful and secure space for Nigerians to exercise their electoral franchise.
Ahead of the National Assembly rerun slated for Saturday, House of Representatives member representing Oshodi Isolo local constituency 1, Mutiu Shadimu, has urged the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, and the security agencies to be apolitical and professional in their services. Shadimu made this known today in an interview with journalists. Shadimu.
The electoral hall allows INEC to conduct election where election could not conduct for one reason or another, and that's why they are doing the by-election. But I would expect the electoral umpire and the government to live up to expectation such that every Nigerian has the right to determine who leads them through the electoral process. Therefore, it is important that government and the electoral umpire provide adequate security to protect life and property of the people and ensure that the will of people prevail on the day of election. Many Nigerians are discouraged, including myself. We are so disappointed in INEC. We are so disappointed in government. We are so disappointed in security agencies for their failure to live up to their responsibilities. The result we have in the election is not a reflection of the will of the people. But nevertheless, I will encourage our people that we continue to exercise that franchise until the right thing is done. Because we don't have any other country, we can call ours, and there's no other process we can elect people except through ballot. Therefore, I will encourage every Nigerian to come out and vote, still exercise their franchise. It's unlawful for anybody to arrest another person, but then that will not stop us from doing what we're supposed to do as a citizen of this country. We should not be discouraged, we should not be coward, we should be ready to exercise that right and ensure we get Nigeria of our wish.
Shadimu further reflects on the irregularities of the presidential election, urging the ruling All Progressives Congress APC to allow the will of the citizens to prevail. He equally decried the treatment of citizens.
Democracy allows anybody to choose their leaders. And you, if you want to seek for their votes, I think you should do the right thing. You cannot intimidate anybody to support you. It's wrong and it's criminal for APC to do all that they did. It's not only Igbos that were harassed. Many Yorubas were also harassed. Some of our supporters were even harassed in the middle of the night. Some of them were even violently attacked in the middle of that. These are in the police custody. These reports, these were given to police, and nothing is done about it. And they are not coming out to apologize. They are only hypocritical. They are not sincere to the principle of democracy. I think they should learn by the rule of law. They should learn to obey the democratic tenets. Democratic tenets is that everybody should vote for their conscience, not by harassing them, not by intimidating them, by your failure to do the right thing for the people. I think they should learn from good democratic countries. So that will help us a lot. It's not enough. The Igbos should not be discouraged. They are citizens of this country, and they have the right to live anywhere they choose to live.
And ahead of the gubernatorial elections, Igbos in Lagos State, under the aegis of Ohanaeze Ndigbo, are demanding the assurance on the safety and security of their properties in the state. Leaders of the apex body of Igbos in Lagos made this demand at a town hall meeting with the All Progressives Congress gubernatorial candidate Babajide Sanwo-Olu recently.
It is town hall meeting of Ohanaeze, and to discuss about the past election of presidency and also the incoming election on the 9th of this month. That's why we are gathering here. The stance of Ndigbo in governorship election in Lagos State, their position, and also the crisis of the past election. And that's why we invite the incoming governor, Babajide Sanwo-Olu, to come and also give us assurance that if our people come out on Saturday to vote him, or vote party of their choice, vote on their conscience, that there will be no problem.
We the Igbos, we have been supporting the APC, we are working for APC, but we are not being recognized, especially in Lagos.
All Progressives Congress gubernatorial candidate Babajide Sanwo-Olu assured the Igbo leaders of maximum security over them and their properties. They immediately endorsed him.
People want to use election. People that are of low mind want to use election to now come and divide us. All of the things you have built, they don't have anything. They are both Yoruba people, they are both Hausa people, they are both Igbo people. They want to use those things to discord us. Let us tell them to get away that we are not about that.
Yes,
we are about development for our state. Your state that all of them elected. This election is not about me. It's not about any of us that are here. It's about our future. It's about people that want to divide us. It's about people that want to begin to use election as an ethnic divide. Let me ask, when we go to the market and buy meat, do we say that we want to buy meat that an Igbo man has killed, or an Hausa man has killed, or a Yoruba man has dissected? When we enter bus, do you say to somebody that, I want to see that the driver of this bus is a Yoruba man or is an Igbo man? When we go to our school and we say that, do we say to them that I want an Igbo teacher for the geography of my student or for the mathematics of my daughter? When we go to the hospital, do we insist and say that I want to see an Igbo doctor or I want to see a Yoruba nurse? We don't do all of this. Why would we allow an event of a day to determine our tomorrow?
We are certainly behind him. When he gets there, he should not forget us.
We want our party to win. We want APC to conquer Lagos.
The Chairman Senate Committee on Works, Senator Kabi Rugaya, APC Kano, says the National Assembly will investigate the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, over the postponement of the 2019 general elections. According to Gaya, the postponement of the election was responsible for the low voter turnout recorded across the country during the just concluded presidential and National Assembly elections. You'll recall that INEC had in the early hours of February 16 postponed the elections by a week, citing logistics challenges. And still on the elections, the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, says 184,678 voters will be participating in Saturday's supplementary elections in Imo North Senatorial District, Okigwe North and Okigwe South federal constituencies of the state, respectively. The State Resident Electoral Commissioner, Professor Francis Ezeonu, who gave the breakdown at a media briefing at INEC's office in Owerri, said the rerun elections will hold alongside governorship and House of Assembly elections. According to Ezeonu, the supplementary election will take place in 149 polling units in Okigwe South Federal Constituency and 153 polling units in Okigwe North Federal Constituency. And the Kogi State Governor Yahaya Bello has signed the state's budget of consolidation into law for the 2019 fiscal year. This comes after members of the Kogi State House of Assembly passed the budget, which has a total of 146.736 billion naira. While appending his signature on the budget, the governor assured the people of the state that the implementation of the budget will be followed to the detail. Governor Bello also described the signing of the budget as another milestone in the history of the state and an opportunity to bring about dividends of democracy to residents. And on party politics, former Director General of the National Emergency Management Agency, NEMA, Mohammed Sidi, has defected to the All Progressives Congress, APC. Sidi joined the ruling party today along with his supporters in Kaduna State, a day after he announced his exit from the People's Democratic Party, PDP. He led all the members of his campaign organization to the government house in Kaduna, where they were formally received into the party by the state governor, Nasiru El-Rufai. Sidi said his decision was a result of the purposeful leadership that has been displayed by the APC administration in the state. And the People's Democratic Party in Delta State has alleged that President Muhammadu Buhari's visit to the state today is aimed at concluding plans by the All Progressives Congress to rig the gubernatorial election slated for Saturday. In a statement made available to Superscreen News, the state publicity secretary Ifeanyi Osoza said the president's visit to the state twice in a month is suspicious, warning President Muhammadu Buhari against alleged scheme to manipulate the electoral process. Osoza, who further condemned the visit of the president to Owerri, wondered why President Buhari would neglect important official matters to visit Delta State twice in 1 month. And on the 2019 Gubba race, Abia State Governor Okezie Igbeazu has directed all the 17 transitional council chairmen in the state to protect all facilities of the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, within their local government areas. The governor in the directive said, apart from the chairman, the deputies should partake in the directive by liaising with security agencies, local vigilante services, traditional rulers, and youths to ensure the protection of all INEC facilities in their domain. You recall that the State Commissioner for Information, John Kalu, had on Friday raised the alarm about alleged plans by political thugs to burn down INEC facilities. And in the education sector, the Joint Admissions and Matriculation Board, JAMB, says it will not rescind its decision on the use of biometrics in the conduct of its Unified Tertiary Matriculation Examination, UTME. The information, which is contained in the board's weekly bulletin, noted that the importance of biometrics in the conduct of the board examination cannot be overemphasized. It said the biometrics verification mechanism, BUM, is a security mechanism used for the authentication of candidates' identity as it provides access to the individual data based on physiological characteristics. And coming up in business, NATO reports Nigeria loses $16 billion production sharing contracts in 10 years. Details on these and more shortly after the break. Do stay with us. Welcome back and many thanks for staying with us on the news now on business. The Nigeria Extractive Industries Transparency Initiative, NATI, says Nigeria has lost at least $16 billion in 10 years due to non-review of the 1993 production sharing contract, PSC, with oil companies. NATI, which made this known in its latest report released in Abuja, said the losses were recorded between 2008 and 2017. The study, done in conjunction with a Berlin-based extractive sector transparency group Open, found that the losses could be up to $28 billion if, after the review, the Federation were allowed to share profit from two additional licenses. NATI therefore called for an urgent review of the PSCs to stem the huge revenue losses to the Federation. And in the financial sector, the Chartered Institute of Forensic Investigative Auditors of Nigeria, CFIAN, says banks in Nigeria may have lost about $25 billion to fraudulent activities in the last 5 years. CFIAN Pro Tem President Inape Aishetu, who disclosed this at an intensive training for CFIAN members, said recorded volume of fraud in the banks increased due to lack of appropriate fraud prevention mechanism.
There is no more hiding place for fraudsters of any kind in our country. Government at all levels are losing billions of naira every day. And most of these criminal cases bordering on fraud, corruption, and cyber crimes are partly lack of forensic and investigative auditors in Nigeria to prevent fraud from taking place in the first place. The place of training of forensic and investigative auditors in Nigeria cannot be overemphasized. Because the world, or the whole world, has embraced this current trend many years ago, which has assisted them in the fight against fraud in their countries.
She also said the aim of CFIAN is to create an instrumental professional paradigm shift in the fight against fraud, corruption, and cyber crimes. And on the economy, the foreign trade in goods report released by the National Bureau of Statistics, NBS, shows that during the fourth quarter of 2018, Nigeria's total merchandise trade stood at 8.61 trillion naira, down from 9.11 trillion naira recorded in the third quarter by 460.96 billion naira or 5.1%. Analysis show that the total export component of this trade was recorded at 5.02 trillion naira, representing an increase of 3.5% over the corresponding quarter of 2017. The import component stood at 3.58 trillion naira in the fourth quarter of 2018, showing a drop of 631.6 billion naira or 15.0% compared to the third quarter of the same year. And now on foreign exchange, the Association of Bureau de Change Operators of Nigeria, APCON, has urged President Muhammadu Buhari to work towards an exchange rate of 250 naira to a United States dollar in his second term in office. APCON President Aminu Gwadabe, who disclosed this in a statement, said achieving a lower exchange rate for the economy will benefit Nigerians and lift businesses. The APCON boss also said such lower exchange rates will improve the transaction volume for BDCs by enabling operators to buy and sell more dollars from their available cash flow. And that does it for business, but still ahead on the international scene. U.S. deadly tornado killed 23 in Lee County, Alabama. Details on this and more on the international scene and sports when we return. Do stay with us.